Ang laman basically ng special occupancies are all the occupancies that are classified as hazardous, no? So that is under normal conditions, no? So under, over, or during abnormal conditions. So yan yung mga special occupancies wherein if we are going to have electrical installation, so dapat meron tayong mga extra precautions, no? Mga extra na mga standards na dapat sundin. So ito yung mga definition ng mga karaniwang terms na makikita sa special occupancy. Of course, these terms are also found on chapter 1, no, ng PEC sa definition of terms. So meron tayong associated non-incentive field wiring apparatus, yung combustible gas detection system, dust ignition proof, dust tight. Tapos meron din tayo ditong explosion proof apparatus. Okay? Tapos hermetically sealed equipment, oil immersion, so purge and pressurize. So ano yung ibig sabihin ng purging at pressurization, tapos non-incentive circuit, non-incentive equipment. So ang mga references for hazardous location is the National Fire Protection Association. So this is sa US, at yung American Petroleum Institute, so also in US, no? So dito meron tayong mga kasama pala yung instrumentation system and automation society, no, as part of the standards, no? The standard reference for this chapter, no? So dito ito yung table natin ng maximum surface temperature, no? So sa code, no, sa code ng mga locations. So if that is, the lowest is 85, which is T6, and the highest is 450 degrees Celsius, which is T1, no? So ito yung hazardous locations. So locations have been classified depending on the properties of the flammable vapors, liquid or gases, or combustible dust or fibers that may be present. So the one reason kung bakit sinasabing they are hazardous locations kasi they have the presence of flammable materials, no, or flammable substances. Either that substance is in the form of vapor, liquid or gas, or dust or fibers. So nakadepende na kung ano yung sa classification. If yung certain location, if sa isang class siya, so ano yun, ano yung presence ng kaniyang flammable. So is it gas, liquid, vapor, dust, or fiber? So kaya dito meron tayong class 1 location, no? So class 1 location, so ang dapat natandaan is may presence siya ng flammable gases or vapor, no? Yun yung ano presence sa kanya, no? Present in air, so sa hangin, so in which is sufficient to produce explosive or ignitable mixture, no? So class 1 location, so they are considered class 1 location if on that location mayroong presence ng flammable gases, vapor sa hangin, na kung saan pwedeng mag-cause ng pagsabog or pwedeng makakause ng sunog, no? Kung pwedeng makapag-ignite ng other na mga substances or mixture. So yung class 1 na divide din yan sa dalawang classes. So first we have class 1 division 1, no? So ang nakalagay sa class 1 division 1, so ignitable concentrations of flammable gases or vapors can exist, existence of gas due to frequent repair or maintenance operation or because of leakage, tapos release of such gases due to breakdown, failure or faulty operation of the equipment, no? Habang yung ano naman, yung class 1 division 2, so volatile, no, flammable liquid or flammable gases are handled, no, process, but in which liquids and gases are confined and can escape only in case of accidental rupture or breakdown or such abnormal operation. Tapos yung sa mechanical ventilation, so meron siyang prevent, no, ignitable concentration of gases, and failure or abnormal operation might become hazardous. Tapos yung gases or vapors might occasionally be communicated unless such communication is prevented by adequate positive pressure ventilation from source of clean air. Okay, so itong sa ano sa class 1 division 1. So there is a concentration, no, of flammable gases or vapor. So either that is due to repair or maintenance or may leakage, no? So or kaya nga may breakdown of certain equipment. Habang sa class 1 division 2, so the presence of flammable gases or liquid are part, no, is part of the process, no? So maring is it the flammable liquid, no, is kasama sa ingredients, no? So kaya it is mas mataas yung kanyang ano, yung kanyang division, kaya siya division 2. So kaya nakalagay din dito dapat mayroong mechanical ventilation. So in case if there is mechanical ventilation, so dapat that mechanical ventilation prevent the concentration of gases or vapors, no? Okay, then we have class 2 location. So class 2, presence of combustible dust, no? So dust. So meron din tayong ano, dalawang classification. So class 2 division 1, so that is the presence of combustible dust under normal condition. So all normal condition na may presence of combustible dust, no, that is under class 2 division 1. If that is class 2 division 2, so abnormal operations or failure, no, failure to check, no, during faulty processes, no, so kaya siya tinatawag na abnormal conditions yung class 2 division 2. The next one is class 3 locations, so the presence of ignitable fibers or flyings, no, so fiber siya. So class 1 division class 3 division 1, so yung ating ignitable fibers are handled, manufactured or used, no, so ito siya yung ignitable fibers, so kasama siya sa process, no, while class 3 division 2 ang pinagkaiba lang is yung ating ignitable fibers are stored, no, naka-store siya sa ating location. So that is, if there is a storage of ignitable fibers, no, so yung mga fibers na maaring mag-cause ng sunog, so that belongs to class 3 division 2. If hinahandle lang siya or kasama lang siya sa manufacturing process, so ang kanyang tawag is class 3 division 1. Then we have the material groups, no, so these are the groups of the materials under hazardous location. So we have MESG or maximum experimental safe gap, tapos yung MIC, that is the minimum igniting ratio. So these are the properties na dapat nandun sa ating mga materials, no, na nasa ating hazardous location. Okay, so class 1 group, no, so ano yan, meron tayong group A, B, C, at D. So, yung A are for acetylene. Tapos, yung group B is for flammable gas. Na yung ating MESG, the value is less than 0.45 mm. Ang ratio naman is less than or equal to 0.40 mm. Habang yung group C, so gas pa rin siya, tapos flammable liquid. Nagkaiba lang is yung ating MSG is from 0.45 mm, but not more than, no, or equal siya sa 0.75 mm. Yung MIC naman, do, the minimum igniting current ratio, no, so that is the ratio is 0.4 and less than or equal to 0.8. Tapos yung group D, so the MSG value is greater than 0.75 and the ratio, no, the MIC ratio is greater than 0.8. So ito lang yung pinakaiba nila, yung MSG at yung MIC. Tapos class 2 group classification, so the group E, group F at group G. So the atmosphere, so sa atmosphere nandun yung combustible metals at dust, no? So including aluminum, magnesium and other commercial alloys. Tapos yung sa group F naman, so they are made up of 80%, no? Total entrapped volatiles. So the usual type of materials is the carbonaceous, no? Dust, no? Example of that is coal, carbon black, charcoal and coke gas, no? So these type of materials are usually used as fuels, no? Especially on coal plants or thermal plants. So ito yung mga ginagamit na mga materials. Tapos yung group G, so containing combustible dust not included in E or F, no? Including flour, grain, wood, no? So tiny dust of wood, plastic and other chemicals, no? So yan yung group G. Tapos meron din tayong class 1, zone 1, 0, 1 and 2 locations, no? So ito yung mga nakalagay sa kanya na mga tagging, no? So types of protections, we have encapsulation. So they are the parts are enclosed, no, which could ignite the atmosphere by sparking or heating. Pwede rin flame proof. So yung enclosure niya can withstand explosion of mixture. Increase safety, E, no? So the applying of electrical equipment, no, does not produce arc. Intrinsic safety, so any spark or thermal effect is incapable of causing ignition. Tapos oil emission, oil ang kanyang tag. So equipment is immersed in a protective liquid in such a way that an explosive atmosphere that may be above the liquid or outside the enclosure cannot be ignited. So meron siyang protective liquid, no? Sometimes it is a non-combustible oil, no? Powder filling, so meron siyang powder, no? So the powder is usually glass or quartz, no? So non-combustible dust, no? Or powder yung nilagay. Tapos type of protection, N. So electrical equipment in normal operation is not capable of igniting a surrounding explosive gas, no? So yan yung type protection N. Tapos meron din tayong classification of locations, no? So class 1, zone 0. So ignitable concentrations of flammable gas are present continuously or for long periods of time. So this is in relation with time. So mas matagal yung time niya pag zone 0. Class 1, zone 1. So may exist under normal condition. Tapos yun nga, repair and maintenance. Tapos equipment breakdown, no? So class 1, zone 2. So these are the ignitable materials, no? So yan yung class 1, zone 2. So zone equipment, so equipment shall be marked with the following order. So yung class, so class 1, yung zone, no? So class 1, zone 2 kapag may ignitable materials. Tapos symbol, protection techniques, applicable glass classifications, tapos temperature classification. So ito yung lalabas, no? Ito yung marking ng ating mga equipment, no, na ating ilalagay sa hazardous locations. Okay. Tapos, so ito, types of protection, no, designation. So katulad nung ito, diniscuss dito sa itaas, no, so types of protection. So ito rin yung kanyang table, no? So kaya D, flameproof enclosure, so that is for zone 1, no? So kapag zone 2, so ito yon, NR, restricted breathing enclosure, no? Tapos zone 20, 21 and 22. Okay. So yung zone 20, hazardous classified location. So an area where combustible dust or ignitable fibers and flyings are present continuously for long periods of time in quantities, no? So quantities which are sufficient to be hazardous. So combustible dust or ignitable fibers. So ang kanyang keyword is continuously. Kapag zone 21, so the same dust and ignitable fiber, pero ang kanyang condition, no? So likely to exist occasionally. So ito 'yon. Ito yung keyword niya. Habang yung zone 22 naman, same, meron siyang dust or ignitable fibers and flyings, but they are not likely to occur under normal conditions. So yan yung kanyang keyword, no? So ito iano ko na lang to. I-underline, no? So yan yung pinagkaiba ng tatlong zone, no? Zone 20, 21 and 22. Tapos motor fuel dispensing facilities. So these are the facilities wherein kung saan natin i-store yung fuel for our motors or for our electrical machines, no? Electrical equipment, no? Okay, so ito yung mga yung diagram kaniyang safe na space, no? So ito, if this is your dispenser, so from side to side, so dapat 600 mm yung spacing. Tapos if you have two dispensers, so ganun din 600 mm, no, from each side. Tapos ito din 600 mm ito mula sa yung pad, no, yung i-raise mo siya, 450 mm from the side of your pad. Tapos yung height ng pad mo from the floor level, that is 450 mm. Okay. So healthcare facilities, so these are the different definition ng healthcare facilities which are also found on chapter 1, no. So ang pinaka dito kaniwang lumalabas is about emergency system, no. Emergency system. Okay. So hospital, isolation transformer, so the general care areas, no. So patient bed location. So at least dalawang branch circuit, no? One for the emergency system and the other is for the normal system. So kapag patient bed location, dapat dalawa yung ating branch circuit, no? Kasi in case of power failure, no, from our distribution unit, so we could use the emergency backup system, no, that is using a generator, no? Generator. Tapos patient bed location receptacles, so it has a minimum of 4 receptacles, either single or duplex types or combination of both. All receptacles, whether 4 or more, shall be listed hospital grade, no, and so identified. So dapat yung mga patient bed location receptacles, 4 yan, no, the minimum is 4 in every patient bed receptacles. Okay, then pediatric location, so these are for the children, no. So receptacles located within the rooms, bathrooms, playrooms, activity rooms and patient care of pediatric wards shall be listed tamper resistant. So ano ibig yung sabihin ng tamper resistant? So there is a mechanism, no, kunyari siguro i-cover yung outlet para hindi siya accidentally na ma-touch ng mga bata, no. So that's why it is the type of receptacle must be accepted or must be listed as tamper resistant. Okay, then we have the critical care areas. So yun, bumaba. So critical care areas. So patient bed location branch circuit, so ganun pa rin, dalawa. Tapos yung isa is for emergency. Tapos yung sa receptacle, 6, no, minimum 6, no. So different siya sa general care, no. Tapos patient vicinity grounding and banding, so meron tayong equipment banding jumper not less than 5.5 square mm, no. Tapos special purpose, so it must be used for mobile x-ray and shall be extended to the reference grounding points of the branch circuit. So naka-grounded siya. Tapos meron tayong maglalagay din tayo ng GFCI for the protection of personnel, no. Shall not be required, no. Tapos transfer switch, no. So we must have a transfer switch. So each branch of emergency system and each equipment system shall have one or more transfer switch. So one transfer switch shall be permitted to serve one or more branch circuit or systems in a facility within a maximum demand of on the essential electrical system of 150 kVA, no? So dapat meron siyang transfer switch. Okay, so ito yung mga for the minimum requirement for the transfer switch, kung ano yung arrangement niya, no? So this is not usually na lumalabas, no, but yeah, it is sometimes described. So dito isa lang yung transfer switch, no, or ito automatic switching equipment. So dito naman sa taas tatlo, no, tatlo yung transfer switch because meron tayong equipment system, life safety branch, tapos critical branch. So that is for emergency system. Ang lahat ng yan that will feed to a essential electrical system on our critical care, no. Tapos task elimination and selected receptacle for critical branch, no. So the critical branch of the emergency system shall supply power for task elimination, fixed equipment, and selected receptacle. So dapat yung ating elimination that is enough for the area, no, kasi lalo na pag hospital yan, so the illumination must be great, no, so kailangan maliwanag talaga siya, no. So for so they are usually naka-focus siya sa critical air areas that utilizes anesthetics, no, anesthetizing gases, tapos special environment, special care areas like infant nurseries, medication preparation areas, pharmacy dispensing, so selected acute nursing areas, psychiatric bed areas, ward treatment rooms, tapos nurse station. Tapos meron ding additional specialized care, no, lalo na yung mga patient which in need of specialized care, no. Tapos narco stations, so dapat may naka-latch din siya sa emergency system. So blood, bone, and tissue box. So especially ito in this part of the hospital or the healthcare facilities, meron siyang storage bank na dapat i-maintain yung temperature. So dapat the equipment must be latched also into the emergency system, no. So telephone equipment, okay. Okay. Then we have assembly occupancies, no? Multiple occupancies. So occupancy of any room or space for assembly of 100 persons or more. So if that is 100 persons or more, so that is now named as assembly occupancies, no? So this type of areas, no, theatrical areas, so there are these are any such building structure or portion thereof contains a projection booth or stage platform or area for the presentation of theatrical or musical productions, no. So example of this one, the common example is yung sine, no, or yung cinema. Okay, so say assembly occupancy shall include but not limited to the following. So ito, so armories, no, storage of guns, no, or artillery. So assembly halls, auditoriums, bowling lanes, club rooms, conference rooms, as long as that is it can hold more than 100 persons, courtrooms, dance halls, dining and drinking facilities, exhibition halls, gymnasiums, mortuary chapels, multi-purpose room, museums, no, places of awaiting transportation. So example of that is the bus or train station, places of religious worship, so mga simbahan, ballrooms, restaurant, and skating rinks, no. So temporary wiring, so it is acceptable na ang gamitin is flexible cords with for hard or extra hard usage as long as they are considered for temporary, hindi siya permanent. So wiring in general, so the fixed wiring method shall be metal raceways, flexible metal or non-metallic raceways in case in not less than 50 mm, no, of concrete. Tapos pwede nating gamitin type MI, type NC, or AC cable with insulated AGC, no. Tapos theaters, no, ito theaters, audience area, motion picture, television. So ito dito mga definition na makikita din sa chapter 1, no? So border light, breakout assembly, bundled, connector strip, so drop box, spotlight group, no, performance area. So the wiring methods, so same lang siya doon sa ano, sa assembly occupancies, no? Sa dressing room, so pendant lamp holder shall not be installed in dressing room. So yung nakahang na mga lamp holder, kasi baka it will cause hazard, no? Especially na baka matamaan ng ano, nag-dress, no? If, in case that the costume itself has mayroon siyang mga ano, mga extra feature na matataas, so maaari siyang masagi, no? Then lamp guards, so all exposed incandescent lamp in dressing room were less than 2,400 mm from the floor. So yung kanyang height is less than 2,400 mm, shall be equipped with open end guards, no, riveted to the outlet box cover or otherwise sealed or locked in place. Switches required, no. So all lights and receptacles adjacent to the mirrors and above dressing table counters installed in dressing room shall be controlled by wall switches, no, in our dressing room, no. Tapos carnivals, circuses, fairs, and similar events. So overhead clearance of conductors. So dapat yung ating ano, ating clearance ng ating mga conductor sa above ng ating amusement rides or attraction, so shall not be less than 4,500 mm. So in any direction, no? So either that is going east, north, south. So any direction, no? Tapos yung rating niya is 600 volt ng ating yung rating ng ating ano wires, no, 600 volts. The disconnecting means, so each ride and concession shall be provided with fuse disconnect, no, or switch circuit breaker located within the, within sight and within 1,800 mm of the operator, no. So kunyari meron tayong roller coaster, so the disconnect or the emergency stop or the circuit breaker dapat that is within 1,800 mm mula sa operator station, no. So that is in case of emergency, so meron tayong other way to stop the ride in case of emergency. Tapos portable distribution or termination box, so where installed outdoors the box shall be weatherproof, no. So ito yung mga ginagamit sa mga station, no, so sa operator station, so lalo na yung mga controller, no, controller for the rides. So dapat the box must be weatherproof construction and mounted so that the bottom of enclosure is not less than 150 mm above the ground. Motion picture, television, and studios and similar locations. So, meron niyang mga definition dito, no? Tapos, when it comes to the projector, so ito yung kanyang film, no? So, 35. So edge is 212 perforation. The workspace, so not less than 800 mm wide, no, in each side and at the rear sa likod. The conductor size, the minimum is 8.0 square mm, no, for the projector. Then mobile homes, manufactured homes and mobile parks. So these are the type ng mga bahay na namo-move, no. So trailer park, no, trailer park ng mga type ng bahay, so usong-uso to sa US, but because our Philippine electrical code is based on the national electrical code, so kaya meron din tayong ganito na standard, no. So ito yung mga definition, no, kung ano yung manufactured home, ano yung mobile home, no. So mobile home not intended as dwelling unit, so shall not be required to meet the population for the number of a number or capacity of circuits required. So if our mobile home is not used, no, for dwelling unit wherein hindi siya tirhan, no, it is not utilized as a dwelling unit, no, so hindi siya tinitirhan ng may-ari on a longer period of time, so parang ano lang, parang during travel lang, kapag nagta-travel lang. So the code, no, the Philippine electrical code has no provisions for that, no. So kaya nga shall not be required to meet the the provisions, no? So yung power supply, if the mobile home is used as a dwelling unit, so not more than one listed 50 ampere mobile home power supply, no? So yan yung kanyang feeder. Ang attachment plug niya, so shall be 2 poultry wire, so rated 50 amperes, 250. And the overall length of the power supply cord is not less than 6,400 mm, no? Okay, so ito yung itsura ng kanyang plug, no? The marking, so dapat may marking yung at ano yung ating plug at yung kanya ding nilalabasan ng ano ng cord, no? The point of entrance shall be in the exterior wall, floor or roof, no? Kasi yung mobile homes nangangailangan niya ng saksakan, no, to operate, no, para siyang mag-operate as a normal house, no. Tapos protected, so shall be permitted to be installed within mobile home walls provided continuous is way having the size of 300 mm is installed, no? That is for the branch circuit. Okay, so we have also the demand factor for service feeders. So if we have one mobile home, so 100%, no? So sa kapag tumaas yung kanyang ano number, so tumataas din yung ating yung ating demand factor is lumiliit, no? Okay, tapos recreation vehicles and recreation vehicle parks. So ito yung definition ng dalawa. So yung cord, so unlike doon sa ano mobile home, so sa ano sa vehicle park or recreational vehicles, that is 7,600 mm, no, from the point of entrance. Tapos ito yung mga attachment plug. Tapos yung label, ilalagay ko ilang amperes, no? So the dimension of the label is 75 mm by 45 mm. Okay, location, tapos maintain demand factor. We have floating buildings, so a building unit that floats on water, no, is more in a permanent location, so nakaano siya, naka-latch or naka yung floating building is naka-fix pa rin siya. So meron siyang roof na nakatali doon sa dock, no, or sa pantalan or sa seaside or sa seashore, no. The location of service, so shall be located adjacent to but not in or on the building or any floating structure. So the feeder conductors, so each floating building shall be supplied by a single set of feeder conductor from its service, no. Tapos marinas and boat yards, no, kung saan doon ginagawa yung mga ano mga barko. So ito yung kaniyang ano ito yung kaniyang mga definition, no. So included dito yung ating mga pier, no. So dapat may electrical datum line, no. So in land area subject to tidal fluctuation, so nagbabago yung taas ng tubig. So the electrical datum plane na kung saan yun yung ating basis for all the heights of our switch, outlet, breakers. So it shall be 600 mm above the highest tide level of the area, no, 600 mm. So the install the electrical datum line for floating piers and landing stages are of the following. So instead to permit rise and fall response to water level without lateral movement. If considering the horizontal plane that is 800 mm above the water level or the landing stage and a minimum 300 mm above the level of the deck. Tapos meron tayong demand factor for boat yards and marina. Okay? Then we will now go to chapter 6, no? So special equipment. So this type of equipment also requires special standards because they usually if hindi maganda yung pagka-install or hindi tama yung pagkagamit, so they can cause also hazard, no? Either electrocution or fire. So una is electrical signs and outline lighting. So meron tayong three types of that types of lighting. So ang markings natin, so for signs and outline lighting system, so dapat nakalagay yung manufacturer's name, trademark or other means of identification kasama yung input voltage and current. So with incandescent lamp holders, kung ang sa loob niya is made up of incandescent lamp holders, lalo na if sa mga billboards, no, so dapat the marking shall be at least 600 mm high, no, 6.0 mm high, and shall be visible during relamping, no. the branch circuit, so incandescent and fluorescent shall be rated not to exceed, so 20 amperes, no? So kapag neon lamp, that is not to exceed 30 amperes, yung isang branch circuit niya. The disconnect, so the disconnect must be inside, no, of the sign, or within the site of the sign or outline system that it controls. Tapos within the site of the electronic or mechanical controllers located external to the sign, no? Tapos the grounding, so signs and metal equipment of outline lighting system shall be grounded. So ito yung kanyang mga grounded. So it will use a flexible metal conduit, no? As long as the length does not exceed 30 meters. Pwede din small metal parts, no? Pero dapat mayroon siyang dimension, no? 50 mm. Non-metallic conduit shall be installed separately and remote. Space, and spacing niya is 40 mm from the system for 100 Hz or less, or 45 mm for system for 100 Hz and over. So ang ginagamit natin na frequency is 60 Hz. So we'll consider the 40 mm. Tapos bonding conductors, so the conductor that will be used for this sa ating electrical signs are not less than, or shall not be smaller than 2.0 square mm. Okay, so the signs in fountain, so shall have a metal part equipment grounding conductor banded. So dapat naka-banding if our signs is subject to water or yung mga sign na makikita natin sa mga fountains. The enclosure, so the enclosure of our branch circuit over current protection is dapat 0.5 mm thick, no? So using sheet steel for enclosure shall be at least 0.5 mm thick, no? Kapag sheet steel, so 0.40, kapag the sheet is copper or aluminum, so 0.50 mm. Then the location, so vehicles, so shall be at least 4,300 mm above vehicles, no? Lalo na sa mga dinadaanan. So pedestrian, so neon tubing installed in pedestrian shall be protected from physical damage. Tapos adjacent to combustible materials, so it shall not be subjected to temperature in excess of 90 degrees Celsius, no? The spacing between wood or combustible material shall not be less than 50 mm. Kapag sa wet location naman, so dapat meron tayong drain holes, no? Okay, so 13 mm yung pinaka malaki na dimension, pinaka mababang dimension is 6.0 mm. Tapos dapat meron tayong ground foot circuit interrupter which is integral to our attachment plug or located in the power supply cord within 300 mm. Tapos yung ballast, transformer and electronic power supplies ng ating electrical signs, so dapat it is accessible. Kapag wet location, dapat weatherproof. The working space, so as usual, the usual working space on electrical equipment is 900 mm, no? Tapos yung attic at soft fit locations, so 600 mm, passageway, walkway naman niya ay 300 mm wide. Okay. Tapos the contact conductors, so they must be guarded, no? So kumbuari insulated siya. The contact wires, so is within less than 40 mm. Tapos yung support along runways, so the intervals must not be exceeding, no? Hindi siya lalagpas yung kanyang interval of 6,000 mm or 6 meters. Tapos support on bridges, so 65 mm. Tapos yung span does not exceed 25 meters, no? Tapos yung support for rigid conductors, so ganun pa rin, no? The shall be carried of insulating support spaced at intervals of not more than 80 times the vertical dimension of the conductor, but no in case greater than 4,500 mm, no? Okay. The clearance, so ito yung clearance, no? Eh, di ba? Ito pa lang clearance. Ito yung demand factor ng ating, electrical sign. So, shall have a minimum of 750 mm to access, no, the live parts where the controls are enclosed in cabinets, no. Tapos kailangan yung ating door, no. As for all enclosure, dapat the door could be open at least 90 degrees, no? Not only for the control panel or the control the panel board for the electrical sign, kahit anong panel board, no, kahit anong enclosure, the clearance dapat yung ating door kapag binuksan natin, it could open at least 90 degrees. If not, dapat the door must be removable. Pwede siya ma-remove, no? So that is yung hinge niya is hindi naka-latch or naka-lock. So, yan yung ano, the standard for ano, doors, no? Doors of enclosures or panel board. So the demand factor, no, for cranes and hoists, so ito. Okay. Tapos yung kanyang opacity ng mga wire, no, for the crane and hoist. So then the opacity factor. So for the elevators, ito yung demand factor natin for elevators. So the competition of the brand circuit is still the same, no? So kahit anong ano, so kahit anong type of equipment. So the control system, ito yung kanyang control system. So ito, this is just a simple flow diagram. So ito naman hindi naman to talaga siya ano, lumalabas sa exam, no. Tapos ang kanyang ano, table of the circuit, no. So ito yung buong circuit ng ating crane and hoist, no. So kasi ang dadalagay niyan is the motor, no. So swimming pools, fountains and similar location, no. So sumuko na tayo. So ito yung mga definition, tapos dapat naka-grounding. Of course, as long as there is a chance na our system could be exposed to much moisture or wetness, so dapat meron yang grounding, no. Lahat ng mga metal parts must be grounded, no. Okay, and also of that, as per standard also, so dapat naka-protected with GFCI or ground fault current interrupter. So the length of our cord shall not exceed 900 mm in length. Tapos ang kanyang minimum na size ng cord is 3.5 square mm, no? Then the overhead conductor clearance, so for swimming pools, so 300 mm above, no? So other clearance parameters, so ito yung kanyang table, no? So kunyari clearance in direction of the water, so ito yung kanyang ano, kanyang standard na height, no, or standard distance from the water. Okay, tapos underground wiring location, so the area shall not the wiring shall not be permitted under the pool or within area extending 150 mm horizontally, no. So pag yung wire mo, for let's say that is 900 mm from the side of the pole, so hindi mo siya pwedeng doon ipadaan yung wire. So dapat that is at least one that is beyond, no? So mas mataas pa siya sa 150 mm, no? Okay, so ito yung table niya, the minimum boreal depth for our rigid metal conduit, no? So iba't ibang conduit. Then the receptacle, so same pa rin, 1500 mm ang kanyang ang kanyang length, no? So the interval, so the, but we have also the general, which is 300 mm. Itong 1500 mm is for this type of conditions, no? Tapos other dwelling locations, so shall be not less than 300 mm from the inside walls of the pool. Tapos ang kanyang dwelling unit naman, no? So the system that we the part, no, sa pool na kung saan nandun talaga nakalocate, no, is that those are usually dwelling units. So dapat ang kanyang ano is 15 to 20 ampere ang kanyang breaker, no, for general purpose, and shall located not less than 300 mm or not more than 6000 mm, no, 3000 to 6000 mm, not more than 2000 mm above the floor or grade level of the serving pool. Okay, so GFCI protection, so like I said, kasi this type of wirings are exposed on moisture, so dapat meron tayong GFCI. Then luminaire, lighting fixture, lighting outlet and ceiling suspended, on paddle fan. So ito yung kanyang minimum na horizontal na distance. Ang height naman niya is 3,600 mm, so above the water level of the pool. Indoor clearances, so shall be protected with GFCI and height not less than 2,300 mm. If there is an existing installation, so the luminaires must be located less than 150 mm or less horizontally from the pool, shall have a height of 1,500 mm. Tapos naka-rigidly attached, no? Fixed talaga siya with GFCI protection. Switching device, so shall be located at least 1,500 mm from the pool and separated by a solid fence wall permanent or permanent barrier. So ito yung ano natin, panel natin, no? The switching device. Junction box and other enclosures. So a junction box or enclosure connected to a conduit, transformer of GI or of similar device that extends directly to a formation or mounting bracket, no, of our luminaire shall meet the requirements. So ito yung kanyang mga requirements. So the construction, the installation, so the vertical spacing, so 100 mm, pwede rin 200 mm. So this is the maximum above the maximum pool water level. Horizontal spacing, so 1,200 mm. Yung flush deck, so that is if you are using 15 volts or less, so a flush deck box shall be permitted if both of the following apply. So an approved potting compound is used to fill the box to prevent moisture. So meron siyang ano, gasket para hindi malagyan ng tubig yung box. Or it is located 1,200 mm from the inside wall of the pool, no? Tapos kasama din sa special equipments are the solar photovoltaic system. So ito yung mga definitions of all the terms na used in dealing with solar photovoltaic system. Now, so meron tayong alternating current photovoltaic module, array. So array are group of solar panels, no? Bipolar photovoltaic array, blocking diode, building integrated photovoltaics, charge controller, diversion charge controller, hybrid system, interactive system, inverter, module, panel, solar cell, no? Solar photovoltaic system stand alone, no? So ito yung mga diagram, no? Ito yung diagram sa loob ng ating cell, no? O sa loob ng panel. Okay? Then this is so ito yung ano, diagram for interactive system, also known as the ano, the tie grid, no? Ito naman yung hybrid system, ito yung stand alone or the off grid system. Okay. The ground fault protection, so kasi naka roof mounted yan, so dapat naka grounded yung ating ano, yung ating support ng ating solar panel. Tapos meron ding ground fault protection. So unbalanced interconnection, so single phase inverters for photovoltaic and AC module is interactive solar photovoltaic system shall not be connected to a three phase system unless interconnected system is designed so that significantly unbalanced voltage cannot result. So hindi natin pwede i-connect yung ating solar panel na single phase naman talaga yan, because that is DC, into a three phase system unless we could assure by design na hindi magkakaroon ng unbalanced voltages, no? So if three phase, so yun talaga gamitin, three phase inverter yung ating gagamitin, no? At the same pa rin, dapat naka-design siya to prevent unbalanced voltages. So marking, ito yung makikita sa marking ng modules, no, yung mga panel. So operating circuit voltage, operating voltage, maximum permissible system voltage, operating current, short circuit current, and maximum power. So including din yan yung name ng manufacturer. So for alternating current photovoltaic modules, so ito. For direct current, ito din yung makikita sa mga marking. Tapos storage batteries, no, shall have the cells connected to operate at less than 50 volts, no, 50 volts nominal. So that's why we are the maximum design voltage for solar is 48 volts, no, kasi as given by the Philippine Electrical Code, so less than 50 volts or at less than 50 volts yung pinakamataas niya na ano, na voltage, system voltage. Okay? Tapos yung charge controller natin, so ito yung charge controller. So ito yung pinaka ano, pinaka highlight nito. The maximum charging current multiplied by 1 R. So that is, kunyari, this maximum charging current is 6. Tapos 6 ampere times 1 R, so that is 6 ampere hour, must be less than 3% of the rated battery capacity in ampere hour, no? Okay, so that is to prevent overcharging, no? Then there is also a feature sa charge controller natin na piniprevent niya yung ano, depth cycle, kung saan bababa talaga yung ating battery. Na mangyayari, the battery will not charge, no? Hindi na makapag-charge yung battery. So meron din yung feature yung charge controller, no? Okay? So I believe that will be all for special equipment and special occupancies, no? So pinaka-importante lang dito talaga, ang usually na lumalabas are the classifications of hazardous location, yung mga zone, itong mga group classification ng mga class 1 na mga location. So yung A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Tapos dito naman sa mga emergency system is the branch circuit, no? The branch circuit and the supply system. Kunyari, if your healthcare facility, kunyari yung hospital mo is supplied, no, by two different power supply, two or more different power supply or power source. So ang tanong dyan is ilan yung ilalagay mo na panel board, no? If you have different power sources, kunyari yung isa is solar, that is for your emergency, meron ka ding generator, meron, at tapos yung normal mo, so normal version is a the distribution system, so bawat isa doon is susupplyan or lalagyan mo ng disconnecting means, tapos overcurrent protection. So kung tatlo, so tatlo din sila. If you have two different supply, but the same ang kanyang source, ang ibig sabihin nun, kunyari, meron kang dalawang grupo or dalawang three-phase, no? Pero same yung pinagkunan mo na DU, no? So, kasi yung ganyang mga ano, nangyayari din yan, that is, if the other substations ng DU na yun is mag-bar down, so meron ka pang isa, no? So that is that, so ang mangyari, dalawa yung ano mo, service drop mo, so yung service conductor mo dalawa, but your enclosure, your disconnecting means is isa lang, no? Isa lang. So ang mangyari doon, meron ka lang double throw or ATS, no? Yun lang yun, isa lang yung mangyayari. But if it is different, iba-iba, generator, solar, kuyari, kung meron ka pang wind, tapos saka na yung DU, so bawat isa doon is mayroong sariling overcurrent protection, no? So overcurrent protection at disconnect. Tapos ang kanilang mga linya is nagko-converge into a transfer switch, no? I think lumabas din yan sa mga nakaraan na mga board exam. If you have a certain system na merong iba't ibang sources, so source talaga, source, no? Hindi supply conductor, kasi yung supply conductor the same lang yung kanyang supply, pero iba-iba lang yung linya, no? Linya ng conductor, but it is energy source. So, bawat energy source, meron siyang isang disconnecting means or overcurrent protection, no? Then, ang ano naman dito is the grounding, no? The grounding of this type of locations, no? So, for the hazardous location, so, itong mga class 1, class 2, class 3, no? If there exists a moisture, no, a part of the location na pwedeng mag-create ng moisture, so dapat naka-grounded lahat ng equipment, no? That because that is also to prevent sparks which can cause ignition, so pwedeng magliyab dahil sa spark. But for other other facilities, no? So kunyari dito sa ating swimming pool, so that is automatic, meron talagang meron talagang fire ano ground fault, no, ground fault protection, tapos grounding, no. Sa healthcare din meron din yan, no, lalo na yung mga part kung saan there is moisture, and also there could be an accidental contact sa mga patient on the live parts of the system, no. So the only facility, no, or location na hindi natin kinakailangan ng grounding is the fire facilities, no, fire pump facilities. Isang building meron tayong fire pump, so yung fire pump, it is not grounded, no, it is not grounded. So yun lang yung ano doon, the exception, no. Other locations, as long as there is moisture, dapat talaga nakaano siya, anong tawag doon, naka-ground, no, naka-ground talaga siya. Okay, no? So the question is, bakit hindi kinakailangan i-ground yung fire pump, no? We are putting ground fault or grounding system because to protect, no, in case na there is moisture, no. So kapag inilagay natin yung ground fault, no, circuit protection yung ating fire pump, what will happen? It will trip, no. The fire pump are usually nangyayari diyan if there is a in case of fire, so talagang nagkakaroon yun ng moisture kasi dyan dumadaan yung tubig, no. So if we are putting a ground fault protection for that one, kapag there is a grounded, no, so na nagtitrip, so ano mangyayari? So yung ating fire pump is mag-off, no. Mangyayari, wala na tayong tubig, no, wala nang magpa-pump ng tubig. So that's why, well, that is one of the main reason. And usually the fire pump in a building is located on the basement, no, basement below, so kung saan it is also subjected to moisture, no. So kaya hindi talaga siya nilalagyan ng grounding, no. So what is, paano mapoprotect yung tao, no, from accidental contact sa fire pump, no, unless if that person is a qualified, no, qualified person. So if you say qualified, he is a licensed electrical practitioner. So the whole fire pump facilities is enclosed on a fence, no, na ang only access is the qualified person, no, either that is the fire department, the fire marshals, or yung electrical, no, the licensed electrical practitioner, which in turn is nagbi-maintain ng ating fire pump. But the most usual na nangyayari kasi sa fire pump, nasa labas naman yung kanyang mga controls, no. Ang ginagawa lang is the checking of the preventive maintenance, kunyari yung insulation ng ating mga motor pump sa fire pump. So yan lang yung ano, preventive maintenance, no. So ginagawa talaga parati kasi walang grounding protection yan. So ginagawa lang, naka-fence lang siya, no. Okay, so I believe that will be all, no. Siguro yun lang yun, no. Kasi ang kagandahan ng dalawang chapter na to is the other standards, no, yung kung ano yung sizing ng breaker, they are found on chapter 2, no, chapter 2. Sa pag-sizing naman ng mga equipment, kunyari may motor, ganyan. So nasa chapter 4 lang yan siya, no. So yung mga full load current, so nandun lang yun, no. But the usual nangyayari, ang talagang lumalabas lang are the different type of special locations, yung classes, tapos yung mga terms related to the occupancies, kunyari itong sa ano, healthcare facilities, no. So yan, ito, so ito lumalabas, ito ano yung ano, itong ambulatory healthcare facilities, no. So yung, so kasi sinabi natin, kapag healthcare facilities, iba din yan sa hospital, no, iba din yan sa healthcare facilities. So yan, lumalabas din yan sa RME board, no. So ang gagawin nyo lang is find the different, no, words na pinagkaiba na. Kahit isang word lang yung makikita nyo na difference or yung tawag ng keyword, no? Kunyari itong healthcare facilities. So, ito yung mga provided niya. Habang yung ano naman, hospital, meron siyang 24-hour basis, no? For 4 or more inpatients, no? So, yung patients yung na-admit ng mga patient, no? So, yan lang yung kanyang, ano, kanyang keyword. Okay? So, I believe we will now go to our practice test. So, ang practice test natin medyo ano lang dito. Maikli lang din, no? But all of these are somewhat part of the hazardous locations, no? Okay, kunin ko muna dito yung link. Okay, so sana ba yung link dito? Wala yung link, ha? Okay. Okay, so yung link is nasa chat box na. You can click that one. Tapos i-start ko na yung ano, yung mga questions. Yan. Okay. Share ko din yung screen dito.